हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग द जजमेंट विच इज़ नोन एज एक्स वर्सेस हाई कोर्ट ऑफ एमपी। दिस जजमेंट वाज ऑथर्ड बाय एचएम जस्टिस बीआर गवाई। द पिटिशनर हैड फाइल्ड आर्टिकल 32 रिट पिटिशन बिफोर द सुप्रीम कोर्ट रिक्वेस्टिंग रीन स्टेटमेंट बैक इन हर सर्विस ऑन द पोस्ट ऑफ जुडिशियल ऑफिसर इन व्यू ऑफ द एक्सेप्टेंस ऑफ हर इनवॉलेंटरी रेजिग्नेशन टेंडर्ड इन पिक्यूलियर सर्कमस्टांसिस of being allegedly sexually harassed by the sitting judge of the Madhya Pradesh High Court. The substance of the petition was that in a disturbed, impulsive and unbalanced state of mind, she sent a resignation to the High Court establishment, which resignation was immediately acted upon, being so accepted in the form of a formal order discharging her from her services. Subsequently, she gave a representation to all the authorities for her reinstatement, which was not attended to, in view of which the writ petition was preferred. Broadly, the Supreme Court held as follows. The transfer of the petitioner when she has lodged a complaint through the district and sessions judge alleging sexual harassment by the sitting judge of the MP High Court was irregular and was unbearable for her to continue. The Judges Inquiry Committee, instituted under the provisions of the Judges Inquiry Act 1968, had found that the transfer was perhaps a precipitated reaction to the complaint being launched by the petitioner against the sitting judge. Expounding and applying the concept of legal malice, the Supreme Court, referring to the judgment of Sri Lekha Vidyarthi v. State of UP, held that violation of Article 14 is occasioned when a state action is not supported by a plausible reason or discernible principle as per the set practices, conventions and policies of the department. Transfer order of the petitioner was clearly in contravention of the transfer policy of the High Court establishment, with a transfer not fitting in within the four corners of the contingencies of mode and manner of transfer laid down under the transfer policy. Thus, the transfer was vitiated by malice in law. The representation of the petitioner opposing her transfer was also not considered in proper perspective favorably, and thus the resignation by the petitioner could not be treated as a voluntary resignation given with free will and choice. The court explained and elaborated on the concept of resignation by referring to law lexicon and the precedents of the Supreme Court to hold what constitutes a voluntary willful resignation. Accordingly, it was held that the resignation was one which was a coerced one, the petitioner being compelled in the extraordinary and peculiar circumstances in her life. Accordingly, the petitioner was reinstated within all consequential benefits of seniority, with the writ petition being partly allowed, however, without awarding any back wages. A celebrated quote of Thomas Fuller, so quoted by Lord Denning, finds mention in the judgment at the end, "Be ye never so high, the law is above you."